Now this ground here is hilly, as you can see. It's been designated as highly erodible land by the USDA. So one cropping practice we use is no-till, which means that the ground is not plowed ever. We plant soybeans into the last year's corn stubble, and we plant corn into last year's soybean stubble. This is rotated in corn and soybeans.
When you harvest, how much of the stock is left?
Well, all of the stock is left on the ground. It just runs through the machine. The corn head pulls the stalk down through it, strips the ear off. The ears go through the machine, part of the stalks, and out the back. And if you'll notice here, those of you on this side, there is residue on the ground. The corn stalks residue that you see is from 2 years ago. Last year, this field was in soybeans. You may see some soybean stubble there as well.
This is bean stubble from last year, corn stalks from 2 years ago.
And that's actually one of the things that Roundup Ready has done, is it's allowed us to do a lot less tillage and protect the soil to a much greater extent.
Toe wall structure. You can kind of see that horseshoe part there looks like a toe, a big toe. We have heavy rains. This will all be underwater. This will be like a big river coming down through this waterway. It comes down, runs over the toe wall structure, and the structure prevents the soil from eroding back. I'll pass around this picture, this aerial photograph. This area right here is what used to be up here where the waterway is. It's an open ditch that used to be here. We filled in the open ditch, put the toe wall structure on the end of it here, and it prevents it from eroding back. This project here probably cost $30,000 in 2003 it was done. It was funded by the Conservation Reserve Program, about a third of it. That's a federal program, and there was a state program that was in effect at that time. They paid for about a third of it. The purpose of that was to keep the silt out of the Spoon River watershed in the Illinois River system. And then I paid for the other third of it. And the cost sharing was significantly important. I probably wouldn't have done this without the cost sharing. In today's dollars, it would probably cost twice that much today to put this in as it did back then.